Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're on Flaming Gorge Reservoir in Utah and Wyoming, fishing with Mike Hall for Kokanee and trout. Now this episode is highly instructional, so if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. Flaming Gorge Reservoir is large enough to cover big chunks of both Wyoming and Utah, and large enough to hold excellent populations of trophy kokanee. Today we're going to learn all we can from Mack's Lure Pro Staffer, Mike Hall.
Okay, to start with, this is the rig we're going to use. We've got a scent chamber in line in front of the dodger. That way it doesn't restrict any of the action off of the dodger. This is a double D dodger. I'm going to go to the center point hookup. These have different actions at different holes. It'll also take it away from the boat. On the back of that, I've got a little kokanee cha-cha in a pink color. This is one of my favorite colors for up at the gorge. Don't forget, you gotta have that little smile blade on there. On the other rod, we're gonna use the double D dodger center hole hookup. We're gonna use an orange UV type squid with a small orange smile blade on it. Now of course we've got double rigs, and the rigs I'm using today are number two hooks rather than the number four hooks. The reason for that is these fish are on pre-spawn. They'll bite an instinctive strike of the hooks, like swim up the side and slap at the lure. And this wider gap hook has a tendency to hook the fish better, so I'll get a lot better return ratio on the number of strikes I get. I'll put more fish in the boat. Okay, we're gonna try down at 60 feet to start with, and I'll be averaging the depth that I see fish on my locator so I can determine which depth is gonna be best. The fish have been running right about 58 to 60 feet. That's where we're gonna start. I've heard some other people been catching them up at 75 foot deep. I'm just about to 60 feet, and the deeper you go, actually, the closer to the downrigger you can run your lure, so we're only running about 4 foot off the release. Another thing I've got is I've got the rod is long enough to extend past the downrigger boom. I'm going to tighten up the tension just enough that when I turn it, it doesn't let back anymore. I'm right at that point now. When I tighten it down, the rod doesn't let back anymore. That means I got all the slack out of my line. What I want to do is I want to be able to tell the pulse of that dodger on the rod tip. And if you look real, real close to the rod tip, you'll see it bounce. Ding, 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 ding. Every one of those is a flash or strobe on the attractor. In this case, the double D dodger. That's what brings that fish to that lure. That's what excites that strike from the fish. Also, a lot of guys like to really torque their downriggers lines down so you have a lot of tension on it. That's great to get the slack out of the line when the fish releases. The real trick is to put a strong enough release on there that when the fish hits the lure, he hooks himself and then releases, or even stays in the release and you have to pop the rod to get the release to let the line go, and then you can play your fish. That way you don't have any slack in the line. If you've got that slack in the line when that fish hits, your chances are about 50-50 that you're gonna lose him. He'll throw the hook. So by tightening it down to reasonable depth, I like to leave a little bit of a loose tip on there. These fish are really slamming this, and they're pretty good size. The first thing I'll do is I'll come over and get all the slack out of the line before I even take it out of the rod holder, and that's to ensure that I have a good return rate on the percentage of how many fish bite the lure. It's not how many bites you get, it's how many bites you convert into fish in the boat. Okay, this is a different rod. We have a shorter length. It's about 10 foot behind the downrigger ball with on an extended release. This rod is a real super light action. It's a 3-weight fly rod. These are great for small lures and great for small fish, but right now we're using a double D dodger and a squid on behind there. It's a little bit heavy for this type of rod. You'll see when I start to let this down, see how much bend I get in this rod? And that's because the rods have got a real soft, light action to it. These ultralight rods built for Kokanee are great in some respects. On these big Kokanee and fish of a lifetime, I'd rather have a rod that performs quite well.
Today we're fishing Flaming Gorge Reservoir with Mike Hall, and right now we're targeting Kokanee. Now on one side of the boat, Mike's fishing an 801 from Lamaglass. On the other, a noodle rod to demonstrate how rod action can make a significant difference in your catch rate.
Okay, and when I tighten this rod up, what I'll do, the tendency with these real light action rods is to over tighten it on the downrigger. That bottoms out the spline on the rod and you have no action, no flex, no shock absorption with the rod. And that's the whole purpose of a fishing rod, is to have a give to it, or bend or flex. Without that, it just doesn't work properly. So in order to get this to tell where I've got pulse rate on my dodger, what I do is I let it out so I'm running a slack line. The drawback to that, to be able to see that dodger tip on there, which I can see now, is I've got a big bow of slack, so when the fish hits it, my chances are going to be 50-50. The hook will throw or not stick in the fish. The fish will be able to release himself before I can get the slack out of it. We'll see what happens anyway on percentages of hookups. The ergonomics on this handle, I can lock it in underneath my arm because it's a little bit longer than the average rod. It makes it really handy for fighting these bigger fish. The other way is I can lock my hand in front of the reel and reel, and then I've got the power and flex of the rod to work the fish, as well as my drag tension is already set perfect on it. Here he comes. Here again, the idea is to hold that fish still when he starts turning back and forth like that. Just hold, stop reeling, and let the fish swim and let him settle down, because if you keep pulling on him, he's going to come unhooked. When he starts swimming, then you can start reeling and he'll come right to the boat that way. And try and keep your dodger in the water, because if they get that dodger up, it works like a lever. They can swing it in midair. It'll cause the fish to throw the hooks. So I try and keep the dodger in the water. I let the fish swim, and when he settles down, I can reel in. He'll swim right up to the side of the boat and I can net him. Okay, this fish is a rainbow, which is even a bonus. Another thing, I've got an 8-foot rod here so I can get out around my downrigger boom. That line touches that downrigger wire, it'll cut it right off. I can hold it out past the downrigger boom to fight the fish up to the side of the boat. No, it is a kokanee. I don't know. Kind of looked like a rainbow there. Got plenty of spots. Correction. Now I drop the rod tip and let the fish swim in. Another thing you can do is bring the fish in, and you want to immediately kick them out of the net. That way they don't get hooked. In this case, I wasn't immediate enough and it got hooked in the net. This time of year where it's warm, you want to immediately put that fish on ice, because if you don't, he's going to turn soft like mush. A lot of people say they're too soft to eat this time of year. All I say is you didn't have any ice in the boat with you. What I started with was a light colored pink. This is a dark waxy colored pink. The color is everything. If you do nothing else with kokanee, pay attention to the color. You can have the wrong lure and the right color, you're going to catch fish. This case, we changed to a waxy color pink. It's almost immediate. I let the downrigger down, had one release, and the fish got off. We trolled another 50 yards and immediately hooked up another fish. So color is everything. If you're not catching fish, change the color. Little darker pink was a trick today. This one also has a silver smile blade, and I like that reflectiveness because I think it's another fish that's on there. It seems to attract them better and excite the strike better with silver in this particular lake. Silver has been my go-to color on my Dodger and on my blades for about 5 years now, and I haven't had any problem putting fish in the boat with it. Okay, we're gonna juice up our scent chamber too. We have a combination of scent products from Procure in there. We'll have to refill it and see what happens next. Got it nice and juicy. He's probably off there by now. No, he's, by golly, he's still there. Didn't pay a drag. I have to be real careful. This fish is right on the surface behind the boat. If he jumps and throws that flasher in the air, he'll throw the hooks. So I'm gonna keep the rod tip down. As the fish squirms and wiggles, I'm gonna stop reeling and let him settle down, and then I'm gonna keep him swimming towards the boat. Just a nice steady pressure when he settles down. It might be a slow fight, but I'll guarantee it's a way to put big fish in the boat, particularly with kokanee.
Welcome back. Now we're catching some nice kokanee on Flaming Gorge Reservoir, but so far all of the strikes have been instinctive, meaning the fish are coming up to the lure and swiping at it side to side instead of biting it. Now that's fine, but what my call suggests is that you use a good wide gap hook to help increase your hookup ratio. Now let's go back to Flaming Gorge.
Once again, see, you can see that fish rolling. You know that he's hooked in on the outside of his mouth. He swam up to the side of it, did a cross sweep. This is a steel gray fish, so we know it's a pre-spawn fish and probably a male. It's a nice fish. He's probably over 3 pounds, this one. This is what you come to Flaming Gorge for right here, folks. Pretty. Yahoo! There he is, classic sockeye. Nice big green head, big old hook jaw. He's led down on the rod and he swims right into there. Now see the hooks on the outside? That's because that fish swam up alongside of the lure and came across and hooked himself. On that type of situation, you want a wide gap hook. The wide gap hooks, these are size 2, which are a little larger than normal. They hook those fish much, much better. You'll have a lot better conversion on bites and strikes that you keep missing with small hooks. If you go to a bigger hook, they pull this instinctive strike, you'll catch more fish with a big hook. Everything you wanted to know about Dodgers, here's what they didn't tell you. This is a ribbon flasher, and this is a rotating flasher. It works by turning over and over and over, rotating. This particular type of flasher, by increasing the bands on the end, will cause it to spin faster, or you can flatten them out to make it spin slower. The difference here is this you control up to 6 to 9 miles an hour with, okay? This is a sling blade, which has a side-to-side rocker action, a classic Dodger action, side-to-side rotating flash. So it actually strobes that flash and attracts the fish. You can increase the action on it by bending the tip again, or flattening it out will decrease the action. This particular lure is designed to troll at about 2 miles per hour. Here we have a couple of the little oval type. These will troll up to between 3 to 6 miles per hour. Because they're smaller profile, they provide less drag on the line. But the action, they work best at 3 to 6 miles per hour. So if you're gonna go a little faster, this is what you want. If you're gonna go a little slower, go back to the standard rectangular type Dodgers. This one has electrolysis in it, it has a kicker blade in it, it spins a lot with the kicker blade. It'll not only go side to side, but it will spin, so it'll have a different action. Primary speed for this style of dodger is 1.5 miles an hour. That's what it will work best at on your rectangular style dodgers. This is a classic for years and years. This is a 4-inch regular dodger. It has a nice side to side swing. It has a pull and stop and start type action with the lure. It has plenty of flash. They come in all sorts of different colors, silver, copper, green, purple, any color you can think of. By putting a spot of paint on there or a piece of reflective tape. But essentially what this does is it works best at 1.5 miles an hour. You can try a little slower, a little faster. What happens if you go slower, it rocks slower and thus a slower flash rate, which attracts the fish. Some days the fish want a little bit more aggressive, so they'll go to a faster flash rate, a little bit faster. And you can see that pulse rate on the end of your rod. Okay, this is the Mack Double D. This dodger will do what no other dodger will do in the world. By adjusting whichever hole you put this in, you're gonna have slight differences in the side-to-side action, and the pulse rate is gonna change. The further out you go, it's slightly slower pulse rate. The closer you go to the center, the faster the pulse rate. Also, by going to these outside holes, it will, as I let it back from the boat, it will swim out from the boat. So if you're stacking, or if you've got nervous fish that you can't get over the top of, this is the dodger you want to use. You can actually take this and hook it up and have your lines crossed behind the boat if you've got it hooked on there wrong. What we did is we put a nice diagram on the back, has all the holes are numbered, has a little diagram of a boat right here. It'll tell you which hole to use for which side of the boat. And you can experiment with the hole you use will determine the action, and how far it swims from the boat will also determine what the fish want. If you do what the fish want, you're gonna catch fish. Ideally, this trolls at 1.5 miles per hour, has a knife edge front, has a nice cupped rear portion to it. That whale tail, as it's bent, causes it to kick and causes it to rock back and forth. Okay, no tuning required. This will work right out of the box. It'll give you a perfect stop and go action. It'll swim to the side of the boat, and it has a variable action with it. No other dodger does that.
We've caught some beautiful kokanee on Flaming Gorge Reservoir this morning, but now the conditions are changing. It's a little later in the day, and the bite has shut off. So Mike made a pretty drastic change. He switched up from a 4.4 Double D dodger to a 7.6 white Double D dodger, and that's just what we needed to get the bite going again.
Something down there, another kokanee. Changing the size of that dodger makes a difference. Just like the rod you use. You can tell stories at the dock or you can catch fish. Here we go. If you notice on this fish, both hooks are on the inside of the mouth. That means that this fish bit the lure. He didn't slap at it, he swam up behind it and chomped on it.
Now you know, Flaming Gorge is famous for its kokanee, but it's also got great rainbow trout. Now, at the time we were filming this episode, I had just come out with my nightmare wedding ring from Mack's lure. Now, and I wanted to see how this lure would do in Flaming Gorge, so I asked Mike to target some trout. Now, he took the lure and converted it into a tandem hook setup using barbarian style hooks, and that was where the barbarian nightmare was born. Now, let's go back to Flaming Gorge and catch a few trout.
Rainbows are up against the shoreline or in the mouths of the bays. They'll be about 40 to 50 foot deep, and there's some real smokers in here. 3 to 5 pounds are average fish. Once in a while, you get one a little bigger than that. We're kind of living close to the edge of the world here today. It's a little cloudy and a little rainy, and we'll see what happens with these storm fronts as they move through. Again, on the rainbows, you want to be at the mouths of the bays or along the face of the channel. You want to be about 40 to 60 foot deep with your lure, and you want to troll in between 80 and 50 foot of water. You'll actually see these fish suspended this time of year, in particular along the cliff walls up and down the lake are real good spots to try, or the mouths of the larger bays.
This is a good one.
This is a good one. This is a fun fishing. Flaming Gorge. This is a good one here. Pretty, huh? Ah, oh, there's a fish on the nightmare over there. Yes, sir. Fish on. I love it when we catch doubles. You know what I really like is I like this rod. This is absolutely the perfect trolling rod. Woohoo, another one. About the same size. Okay, got hot wings on this one as an attractor. Then I've got my scent chamber, and down below I've got the new nightmare wedding ring. As you can see, I'm having fun. Another fun fish from Flaming Gorge. I sure wish you were here.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.